Hi, it's Doug. I want you to think back to when you were just a little kid. Maybe you don't even remember it that well. You were so young, and when you were learning to walk, at some point, walking around, you looked down and you noticed for the first time this, your shadow. It's all dark, and it seems to keep following you everywhere you go. Some little kids are even scared of their shadow when they see it.
Your shadow.
And it's not just kids who notice their shadow for the first time. Look at this. This dog is noticing its shadow, and it seems to want to chase it away. I guess shadows are a little scary. They're dark, and they keep following you. As we get older, we all figure out that our shadow isn't something to be scared of. Your shadow's not something you can ever get away from. There's no leaving your shadow behind. Your shadow moves because you move. But could the shadows of other things move? I mean, things that aren't alive, like a building shadow. Could it move? Or the shadow of this fence? Or the shadow of this statue? Could a statue's shadow move? Maybe you're thinking, no way. The only way a shadow would move would be if the thing itself moved. And a statue doesn't move. But if the statue moved, now is that the only way for its shadow to move? Could there be another way? Well, I have an idea about how we could find out. Now, sadly, I don't have any great big statues nearby me. But here in the Office of Mystery Science, where I work, we do have this little gnome, and he makes a good statue. His name is Willy. My friend is going to put Willy in the sun, where he makes a shadow. You see his shadow here? My friend is also going to trace Willy's shadow on a piece of paper, so we'll know if his shadow moves. Now, let's leave Willy here for a while. We'll come back and check later to see what happens. While we wait, though, I have a question for you. I sent it to your teacher so that you can read the question together.